The City of Brotherly Love, Philadelphia, was the backdrop for the 66th National Convention of the Pan-Macedonian Association, USA. Sunday morning saw a group of 50 conventioneers walking Ben Franklin to church. The group of 50 strolled 12 blocks through the historic parks and streets of Old City, Philadelphia. That started at the hotel and ended just in time for church at St. George Greek Orthodox Cathedral. Sunday afternoon's panel discussion featured perhaps the world's most topical subject in the news for the last 2 years, Greece and the Euro economic crisis. The forum began with an introduction offered by an actor playing Alexander Hamilton, a founding father, economist, political philosopher, and the first United States Secretary of the Treasury. Panelists from the academic, publishing, and economic fields lectured on the topic to a full room of attendees.
We had a wonderful discussion about the recent developments of the Greek crisis. We discussed the precipitant circumstances under which Greece has been under a lot of pressure to reform its economy. We discussed matters related to the global Greek crisis and the implications of the Greek crisis to other economies in the Eurozone, as well as some social issues as a result of the Greek crisis. We thought that the discussion was very good. We had six panelists, and two of them came from Greece, actually. And I was very privileged to participate and express my views as to what were the causes and the potential solutions to the Greek crisis.
Could you just give us a couple of key examples of what were the specifics that people were focused on?
We focus mostly on what will be the next development for Greece, whether or not there is an exit or the possibility of restructuring of the Greek debt. We thought that a lot of actions need to take place for the structural changes in Greece, opening of various professions, but also enhancing the competitiveness of Greece in the Eurozone and in the global economy. And also we talk about the political difficulties that Greece goes through, and what will be the response of the Europeans. I mean, a lot of things are speculative at this stage, but the reality is that even though Greece is only 1.5% of the GDP of the European nations, the impact of a potential Greek default, it's really at the global level. It's not only a European issue, it's a global issue. And this is what everybody needs to remember. And we hope that with the recent changes in France and the closer collaboration between the European countries, perhaps Greece can be farther developed with a growth plan as opposed to a complete austerity plan.
We heard that there seemed to be a couple of occasions where they said the country will collapse eventually. Do you agree? Can you give us a prediction on where Greece will be 6 months to a year from now? Your own opinion here.
There is no way to get out unless you change your mindset. Yeah, this is collapsing. I mean, if the assumption is it's going to happen, what happened to the Soviet republics, the former republics of the Soviet Union, we saw a collapse. We are so lucky to have European Union, but we need our allies and business partners and European partners are frustrated at us doing nothing. So we are gonna collapse, yes, but at our own responsibility. We don't wanna change anything. I mean, and I give you a very simple example, the reforms in education. I mean, the higher education reform was voted by 270 people, 90% of the parliament, and cannot be implemented. It's a classic case of resistance to reform, that everybody agrees still implementation. I am afraid that unless we act with urgency and change our approach, it's going to be painful.
Sunday evening, approximately 350 people attended the Black Tie Gala banquet of the convention.
I think it's been going great, and I think the most important thing in my mind is that the society model for the Greek Federation and Greek societies shows that it still works. Because a lot of people have been saying the societies are dead. But this is living proof, with over 350 to 400 people expected to show up tonight. And the fact that it was a four-day event, we've got people from Los Angeles, Houston, Washington, Baltimore, Athens, Thessaloniki, Boston, New York. It goes on and on and on. South Carolina, Florida. It's amazing. And that's what makes me happy, that Greek societies are alive and well. And the Macedonians have really done a good job with this. So,
the event opened with an energetic dance performed by the Pontian Society, Akrite, Youth of Greater Philadelphia. Additional remarks were then abruptly interrupted by a surprise crowd-pleasing skit performed by two actors playing Pavlos Melas and Alexander the Great.
Γιατί ήρθες εδώ στη Φιλαδέλφια, με άγροδο.
Κουβού και πάλας, απ' έξω είναι.
Και παρκάρισες με το βαλέι.
Τι λες καλέ, να μιστέψω κάποιον άλλον με τον Βουκεφάλα και να πληρώσω και 30 δολάρια. Εμείς, Παύλο, ένα πράγμα πρέπει να καταλάβεις. Εσύ είσαι ο Παύλο Μελάς. Κι εγώ, ο Μέγας Αλέξανδρος. Εμείς κάνουμε ό,τι θέλουμε.
Ακριβώς.
Τι λες,
πάμε για ένα ποτάκι.
Ναι, ήρθε η ώρα. Άντε, όλοι μαζί, ας κοντήσουμε απόψε.
Γεια.
The Pan-Macedonian organization then went on to recognize individuals and past presidents. The Spirit of Macedonia group from Philadelphia wore traditional masks and carried swords as they performed dances from Nausa, Greece, featuring bulls, yenitsari, apokrias, pre-Lentil carnival dances. The four-day event in Philadelphia was arguably one of the most ambitious and successful conventions of the Pan-Macedonian Association in years. Congratulations to the Pan-Macedonian Association of Philadelphia for a great weekend.
Μόνο από την περιοχή.